Siswa, ya, saya juga begitu. Okay, then, guys, I remember, like, I didn't give you the reported speech, right? I just gave you the homework to write a story, a narrative story from your past experience or your childhood experience or the most remembered experience. Am I right? So, before we continue to the next module, our today's topic, which is narrative 2, we are going to review a little bit about reported. Yes? At least 300 words. Yeah, sure. Paling sedikit 300, kalau lebih ya nggak apa-apa. I saw some stories like a full page, and then I enjoy reading the page because I just give some grades to maybe like 5 people because I did that yesterday. Maybe the rest will be like tonight. It's okay. All right. Okay, so before we continue our topic module 6, narrative 2, so let's review a little bit about reported speech. Okay, so last 2 weeks we talked about reported speech, and then we talked about irregular verb, right? So what is this irregular verb? Irregular verb. Yes, kata kerja tidak beraturan ya. So, we use this one when we want to talk about something already past, which is in the past tense, yeah? For example, we have regular verb and then we have irregular verb. For regular verb, give me some example of regular verb. Yes, write, wrote, and written, yeah? Okay, other than that one, can anyone give me another one? Yes. So for regular, we mostly use ed at the end of the word, or we put only d, right? For example, cook, we have cooked, we plus ed. But for something that we use only d, what is that? Can you? Only d. Sprayed. Oh, separated. Yeah, separated. Yes. Jadi itu cuma ditambahin di. Lalu tadi yang regularnya tadi mbaknya bilang write, wrote, and written. Yes. And then ada juga dia irregular, but then the word doesn't change. What is that? Yes, read, read, and read. Ya. Jadi yang untuk kata kerja kedua dan ketiganya itu sama tulisannya, tapi pelafalannya beda, read and read. And it depends on the sentence, so we need to see the sentence carefully. Ada juga yang put atau meletakkan ya. Jadi itu juga sama irregular, and the word doesn't change. Alright, so that's about irregular and regular verb. And then how about passive? How about reported speech? What is reported speech? What is reported speech? Yes, mengatakan ulang sesuatu yang udah dikatakan orang lain, ya. Jadi dia itu tidak secara langsung lagi bahasanya, kan? Oh, kata dia seperti ini, dia bilang seperti ini. Oh, dia meminta saya untuk seperti ini. Jadi untuk mengulangi apa yang sudah terjadi. Okay, so let's see the example. Karena kemarin nggak ada saya buat untuk tugas. Let's see the example here. Can you guys see it on the screen? Bisa lihat di screen tak? Okay, for example, number one, he said, I will be here at noon. And then, untuk diubah ke indirect speech atau reported speech, he said that he would be here at noon. Do you guys to remember like how we need to change the past tense, the tenses? Kalau kira-kira lupa bisa dilihat modulnya ya, halaman, let me see. Itu modul 5. Siapa tahu ada yang lupa. Modul 5 halaman 5.14 itu untuk menentukan tensesnya seperti apa pada saat diganti menjadi reported speech. Okay, number 2, let's see here. Mary said the train will probably arrive on time. Okay, how do we change this one into passive voice? To indirect speech. Mary said that the train would probably arrive on time. Yes, how about the other guys? Gimana menurut kalian? Benar nggak? Setuju nggak? Atau you guys don't agree on this one? Setuju gak? Seperti itu jawabannya. Mary said the train would probably arrive on time. Yes, ini di PPT, di screen. Jadi harus lihat screennya. Okay. Gimana yang lainnya? Yes, jadi benar ya. Jadi di sini kan will itu harus kita ganti menjadi past future. Jadi the train would probably arrive on time. Okay, number 3. Siapa yang mau coba nomor 3? Okay. He said that he had to finish. Is it okay? He said that he had to finish that. Okay, column, yes, kalau misalnya this kita ubah menjadi that ya. He said that he had to finish that report by 5 o'clock. Okay, number 4, coba. The doctor said that Mr. Smith would improve quickly. Yes, the doctor said that Mr. Smith would improve quickly. Yes, correct. Number 5, ini yang lain nggak bisa ngomong apa bagaimana? Lagi bekerja? Wah, banyak yang lah sambil kerja ya. Okay, and then number five. Coba yang bisa aja. Okay. Okay, that I di situ yang ngomong siapa? Okay, yang ngomong si William, jadi apakah kita harus menggunakan I lagi atau? Okay. Yes, William said to me that he was leaving in the morning, yes. Jadi present tense kita ubah menjadi past tense. Okay, next one, number six. The teacher said everyone has to write a composition. Gimana itu cara mengubahnya? Yes, jadi kita coba mengubah has itu aja ya, has-nya menjadi past tense. Yaitu the teacher said that everyone had to write a composition. Yes. Okay, next one. The John said I saw the movie on Wednesday. John said that I-nya harus kita ubah menjadi he saw itu past tense. Jadi past tense harus kita ubah menjadi yes, past perfect. John said that he yes, had seen that movie on Wednesday. Okay, kita juga bisa bilang seperti ini. John said that he had seen that movie last Wednesday. Last Wednesday. Jadi kita bisa ubah on itu menjadi last. Yeah. Next one, number 8. Helen said, I have read that book. Helen, she okay, she has or she had? She had, ya, karena kita harus ubah ke past perfect. Jadi Helen said that she had read that book. Jadi itu bukan read lagi tapi read. Number 9. Mary said to John, I cannot go to the movie with you. Okay, to the movie with yes, with him ya. Karena ini percakapan antara si Mary dengan si John dan kita mengatakannya ulang. So Mary said to John that she couldn't go to the movie with si Johnnya yaitu with him. Alright, number 10. John said, I have finished studying my lesson. Is it my lesson? Him lesson? His lesson. Yes, John said that he had finished studying his lesson. Yes. Easy, right? Gampang, bukan? Gampang-gampang susah. Okay, the next one. It's about the question word. Question word. Where is the post office? She asked me. She asked me. Where? Don't forget. When it comes to the question word, and then ketika dia itu ada question word-nya, subjeknya itu bukan ya subjek atau helping verb-nya itu bakalan datang di akhir kalimat. So how do we need to change this one? Okay, into present tense, but then we need to change into past tense. Yes. Yes. Where she asked me where the post office was. Jadi itu pakai was ya. Number 2. Oke, okay. This one also kita juga harus lihat yang seperti ini. Ketika dia itu memang dia pertanyaan, tapi apakah dia itu menjadi kalimat yang utuh ketika kita membuat helping verbnya di belakang? Nah, seperti yang tadi saya bilang, oh helping verb itu bakalan di belakang kita buat setelah di akhir kalimat. Tapi ada juga helping verb yang tidak bisa dibuat di akhir kalimat seperti nomor 2. Kena. Yes, jawabannya itu. Tapi bentar dulu, saya jawab Bu Ani dulu. Kalian bisa lihat screen-nya jelas tak? Bisa Ibu Ani. Jadi mungkin jaringannya Ibu kali ya. Oke, okay, nomor 2 itu why is Julie sad? She asked me why Julie was sad. Yes, jadi dia itu datang setelah si subjeknya. Why Julie was sad. Tadi juga yang nomor 1 sebenarnya sih datang setelah subjek ya. She asked me where the post office. Jadi the post office-nya itu si subjek. Lalu datang si helping verb atau verb-nya. Number 2, why is Julie sad? She asked me why Julie was sad. Yes, how about number 3? Mm-hmm. She asked me what was for dinner. Okay, number... Is it she asked me what was for dinner or she asked me what for dinner was? She asked me what was for dinner or she asked me what for dinner was. Yes, she asked me what for dinner was, yeah. She asked me what for dinner was. All right, number 4. Who is the woman in the red dress? Okay, how about the others? You want to try? Ada yang mau coba? Okay, was itu datang setelah subjeknya. She asked me who. Yes, who asked? She asked me who. The woman in the red dress was. Jadi ketika udah kita ubah ke reported speech, kita nggak menggunakan question mark lagi ya. Kita menggunakan period atau full stop, titik, nggak tanda tanya lagi. Number 5, who is your grandmother? She asked me, how atau who? Oh, how ya. Okay, sorry. She asked me how. Okay, dia nanya, how is your grandmother? How are you? How gonna you answer that question? You are fine atau I am fine? Your? Okay, so here. Yes, jadi di sini your itu menjadi my. Ya? Yeah? You menjadi I. Jadi kalau someone ask you about you, and then you're gonna answer with I, right? And then it's the same here. How is your grandmother? I'm gonna say like, oh, my grandmother is okay, right? So here she asked me how my grandmother was. Jadi itu menjadi my. Any questions so far? Susah? Kenapa susah? Di mana susahnya? Pokoknya itu si is, am, are, atau helping verb yang lainnya itu datang setelah si si subjeknya, si kata tanya, subjek baru helping verb. Dan kita tidak menggunakan question lagi. Oke? Okay? Satu lagi deh, ini. Nomor yang terakhir. Ini. Ini yes, no question. So, when we want to change a yes, no question into reported speech, what do we need to put in the sentence? Do you still remember? Do you still remember what we need to put in the sentence? We need to put if. Jadi kita itu kan udah ada if-nya di sentence. Okay, let me do number one for you. Like, I change the direct question into reported speech. Is John at home? And then she asked me if John was at home. Okay? Jadi itu sama juga present tense. Si is kan? Is itu present tense. So, ketika kita mau ubah ke reported speech-nya, kita menggunakan past tense. Jadi, she asked me if John was at home. Okay, number two. Coba siapa yang bisa? Okay. Yes, she asked me if I was late. Okay, number three. Coba, number tiga. Yes, she asked me if it was cold outside. If it was cold outside, ya. Apakah di luar itu dingin atau tidak? Okay, number four. She asked me if they were in Paris. Yes. Number five. Is the bus stop near the shopping area? At the shopping center? How is the reported speech? She asked me if the bus stop is menjadi was. She asked me if the bus stop was near the shopping center. Yes. I guess it's easy. I guess. Maybe. Okay? Okay. So, any question about reported speech so far? No? Kalau tidak ada, then we can continue to our next topic, which is narrative. Still bagian yang dari yang kemarin kita bicara tentang naratif, tapi yang naratif satu. Dan grammar fokusnya itu reported speech sama apa regular verb, irregular verb. So now we want to talk about narrative two. So what do we expect? What are the students expected to be able to after learning this module? So the first one, you are able to develop your stories from news headline. It's news headline. Itu soalnya itu ada disnya. Number two, the second one, you guys, or we can write a narrative poems. And then the third one, produce imaginative stories. Atau you need to make up a story. Okay, so the first one, let's continue. The first one kita ada ada unit one, yaitu headlines. So, what is the function of headlines in newspaper and magazine? Other than to encourage people, yeah? To buy the magazine or newspaper. What is the function? What is it for? The headlines. Okay, it's a summary about the news. How about yang lain? Ada jawaban yang lain? You can also open up your book page 6.2, yeah? Summary of the news. Any other? To attract, ya. Jadi headline itu juga bisa sebagai attraction, attractions untuk some readers atau misalnya orang yang jalan melewati si magazine dan si newspaper. Sometimes people really don't. For example, I don't really like to read magazine, but then if I see any catchy and catchy headlines, maybe I will attract to read that one, ya. Kadang mereka itu bukan karena mau membaca, tapi karena feel attracted. Oh, this title is really good, maybe. Jadi dia itu untuk sebagai menarik perhatian si pembeli magazine atau pembeli majalah atau the potential customer of newspaper atau magazine. Okay, and then the next one, a news headline gives a small hole to peep the whole story. Jadi tadi yang mbaknya bilang, the summary of the story. Yes, itu juga bisa. And then, for example, kita bisa lihat contohnya di sini, nomor satu, 5 students killed in a train crash. Nomor dua, a stranger robs Taiwanese driver in the US. And then Jokowi to Russia, for example. Jadi ketiga contoh ini juga bisa menggambarkan headline news di dalam newspaper atau magazine. Okay, coba contohnya di sini. 4 Israeli soldiers killed in Lebanon. Bisa juga kalian lihat di buku page 6.3. Coba yang bisa baca, satu orang sampai border. Dibaca satu orang sampai yang border, paragraf 2. Oke, 1-2 ya mbak, silakan. Yes. Okay, thank you. The next one. Ada yang bisa baca? Paragraf 3 dan 4. Okay. Okay, alright, the last one, dua paragraf terakhir, silakan yang bisa baca. Okay, Mbak Diana. Yes, itu ada soldiers, ada wounded, ya, itu wounded. Okay, so title-nya di